So the stuff that gets me excited about this conversation about democracy and participation is that we can tend to think about democracy as what people do at a ballot box or showing up to a meeting or how many votes are cast. And by thinking more about participation as a key element of democracy, then we reframe the conversation. And so we can think about democracy as people participating in their lives in meaningful ways, that people are actively engaged, are at whatever level, in whatever way makes sense for them. So the own, use, serve, belong framework, for example, ties very closely to what I think of as the I go back to the definition of cooperatives, where we are both simultaneously an association and an enterprise.
They put in the word association and they put in the word enterprise. And a cooperative is both those things. Every cooperative everywhere, by definition.
And how do we think about our relationship within the association? Well, we might think about it as we belong to the association, and how do we then participate in that association that we belong to? So we might be participating in social events. We might be participating in voting for bylaws, whatever that might be. But it's a participation that would matter to me and as an individual member. And then in the enterprise, how do we participate there? We participate by using the enterprise for food co-ops, by shopping at the store. We participate by showing up at meetings, perhaps. We participate maybe sometimes by running for the board. We participate by choosing to perhaps buy more local product because we know that's the value of our co-op. So the keys for me are that democracy is an active process that each of us as citizens chooses how we're going to participate, as opposed to someone with a higher authority telling us how we're going to participate, and that there are many ways to participate, and each of us gets to choose ways that are meaningful to us. So from a leadership perspective, what that might mean is that we look for indicators that our members are participating. We don't get too tied into, so for example, we might look at, are people casting ballots in an election for the board, or are people showing up to a member meeting? And those indicate something about that kind of participation. But what's even as important is that we look for other indicators of participation so that we can have a broader understanding ourselves of if our members are participating and how they are participating. And on the other side of it, so besides just being passive and observing, also being actively engaged in thinking about and creating opportunities or encouraging opportunities to be created for different kinds of participation. So not to spend all of our limited resources on just trying to get people to show up to the annual meeting or just trying to get more people to cast a ballot for the board, but to think about there are all these different ways that people can participate in our co-ops, and we want to be making sure that the doors are open, that people in our community, members in our cooperative, know that the opportunities exist and that that they are welcome to find a place that is meaningful for them to participate. This would matter because we live in a world and in a society, in particular this country, where we talk a lot about democracy and whether it's working or not. And I think we have the opportunity in the world of cooperatives to lead the way in demonstrating what a strong, powerful, meaningful democracy can look like. That's our role in society, that no one else can do that as well as we can. And this is our time, this is our decade, to really put thought and energy into that. And it'll make a difference not just for our individual co-ops and our communities, but for those communities as a whole. And I really do think it'll make a difference for our entire country.